Hey guys, how's it going? Sky over here for SKY. Another cafe over here in Malaysia, probably one of my favorite cafes. It's right near my house right now. It's called After Black, right next, like across from Sunway University. Really good food. Coffee's not bad either. And of course, you can see the coffee's really good. I'm already done. Today, I wanted to share a little bit in my vlog, another kind of funny experience I had here in Malaysia. I was at this cafe visiting for like maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours max. Finished all my work, I go outside, and my car is gone. Like literally my car, I'm like, where the heck is my car? Where my car was, it was parked, there was another car there. And I was like, this doesn't make any sense. I kept looking around, but honestly guys, the parking lot in front of this cafe fits about, I would say 15 to 20 cars max. But for 15 minutes, I'm going around like, where's my car? I'm looking at the same 15 cars over and over and over again. I can't really believe it's my car is gone. So then it kind of gets to my head like, I wonder if it got stolen. It's my friend's car. I'm like, oh my gosh, did my car get stolen? So now I'm like getting a little bit worried. There's like a bunch of businesses and there's a bank like right where my car was parked and there's a security guard. So I go over to the security guard and I'm like, hey bro, did anything happen with my car? He's like, oh, your car. I was like, yeah, he's like, they towed it. What? Why would they tow it? Because, you know, I'm looking around. There's another car parked in the exact same place. I'm like, what am I missing here? Why did it get towed? I call the tow place and they're like, yes, we towed your car. And I was like, why? And they're like, because you parked illegally. There were like 10 other cars parked illegally there too. I'm serious. And I was so angry at that point. I even hung up on the woman on the phone and I was like, what the heck? And I was so angry. I started going around the parking lot and other parking lots, taking pictures of cars that are parked illegally. I knew inside, I was like, it's not gonna change anything. Like, it's not gonna make them take my ticket off. But I was so angry. Just taking picture after picture, like, see this? I'm gonna show it to them. These guys are terrible. And even in my head, I thought they were like, why are they picking on me? You know what I mean? What do? I call my friend. Friend comes over. I was like, hey, take me to the tow truck, towing place. And they're like, what? What happened? I was like, I was parked illegally. But you know what? We're in Malaysia. Everyone parks illegally. Like, this is one of the only countries that I know where you can park, triple park. Right? And then you could do all, like you park anywhere you want. And I was like, why the heck would they pick on me? So my friend drives me to the tow truck place. And on the way there, I'm just venting like crazy. I'm venting like, man, this is so unfair. Like there's so many cars parked illegally here. Like I'm not the only one. Why would they choose my car out of all the cars kind of thing? And I was like, man, I hope that cars fall from the sky and they land on all the people that towed the cars and then lands on the building and crushes everything and then more and more cars come and hit those people and smash them so that they become flat like pancakes and they become pancake people and then dogs will come and eat the pancake people. So my friend is looking at me like, what? Like pancake people? And you know, when you're angry, you don't realize how stupid you sound. But this person was laughing at me and I was like so angry, right? We got there and you know, I looked at the website. It's gonna be about 200 ringgit, it's about $50. And I was like, this is expensive, right? So I go and they say 310. I was like, what? Like, what the heck? And then well, you had a clamp and it's like 50 ringgit for the clamp and then like 60 for the rental of the lot. I'm like, what the heck? And I was even more angry, right? And I pick up my car and my friend takes me to lunch, so I feel a little bit better about myself. That's my story. I call it the pancake people story, right? I was so mad. But there's something very interesting. There's a couple things I realized from this that I think that a lot of us can relate to. Number one is, because even now after I calm down, you know, obviously I'm not really meaning that I want people to die and be flattened by pancakes by cars that fall from the sky. Like obviously that's not true, right? And of course, I'm gonna be honest with you too. At the time I was so angry, I really wanted, like, I'm saying this because I'm so angry. And, but you know, later after you realize that you don't really mean it and you laugh about it after. This is what people are like when they're really, really emotional and we might say things we regret, but we don't really mean it. And the reason why that kind of opened my mind a bit, like when other people get angry and mad, or they might say something bad about me, they may mean it at the moment, but they may not really, really mean it. It's just their expression of their anger towards me or something along that line. And you know, when we get angry at each other, we can kind of get a bigger perspective of what's going on when people are angry or sad or emotional. We might say things that we really don't mean. Second thing I really liked about this situation was I had a friend to talk to that when I expressed everything, they laughed at me and it made me realize what I was really saying. I'm like, pancake people, and they're laughing, like pancake people. And I'm like, yeah, pancake people. Wait, that sounds stupid. And it brings you back to reality, like you're just saying stupid things. And I was like, yeah, I think I'm just saying stupid things. It makes me thankful that, you know, a lot of times when you guys are going through something, more than just holding it in, it's good to have a good friend around just to let it out. They'll laugh or they'll support you emotionally. And I think it's something that's really healthy for all of us to have in a relationship. Don't keep it in, guys. Just tell someone. And I think that'll be something that'll help a lot of us in the future so we don't do more stupid things or say more stupid things too. That's my vlog for today. Like and comment. I want to hear what stories you guys have. That would be kind of cool to hear these types of stories that you guys have. And if you really like it, go ahead and share the content with other people too. All right, everyone have a wonderful day. We'll see you guys again next time on my next vlog. Later.